What's going on, everybody? Hope everyone's having a fantastic evening, afternoon, evening, no matter where you are in the world. I'm Assam Piker, and this is the Hassan Abi broadcast coming to you live from sunny California, Los Angeles, folks. We're live and alive, and I hope all the boys, I hope all the girls, and I hope all the MBs are having a fantastic one. Because today's a beautiful day. It's actually not a beautiful day. It's a gloomy and dark day, but still a beautiful one regardless. Here in sunny, well, not sunny, dark and gloomy California, Los Angeles. Live and alive, folks. Friday, October 14th, 2022, 11:11 a.m. And California is gloomy, folks. That's why I'm wearing this hoodie. That's why I'm being cozy with it right now. I'm being cozy as fuck with it right now. That was written and produced by Vorlo, sang by Sebadentist. That was Esperando a Hassan. I hope everyone's having a fantastic one, folks, because today is a wonderful day. Regardless of whatever kind of day you're having, it doesn't change the reality that today is.
You know we finally here, right?
Well,
it's Friday then.
That's right.
It's Saturday, Sunday, what?
It's Friday, fucking Friday, baby. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Time to do some cat cows. My neck is so fucked up still. I can't move it. I thought I would be able to do a fucking cat cow, but I was wrong. That was not good. That was not a good attempt. I can't even do a fucking cat cow still. Holy shit. I thought I would do the threading the needle. You know what I mean? I thought I would be doing some quick yoga examples. You might be able to do a cat cow if you face the back wall. Mashallah, Hassan was doing dua for Jummah. Yeah, it's Jummah, and we're all going to Jannah. That's getting old. That's the kind of content you get when you get your notifications on. That's right. Merch drop has been pushed back next week. I apologize. I decided it would be better to do that. Why is my neck hurting? Because I'm sucking off Vladimir Putin, dude. My favorite politician, you know what I mean? My favorite world leader. I'm sucking him off. That's why my neck hurts. Giving him the Gluck Gluck 3000, you know what I'm saying? Blast off pre-ready. Have you heard of the Ma situation? What? My dick in your mouth? I haven't. That's why we aren't at full-blown World War III right now. Yeah, dude. I'm giving him the glug glug so he's not... So he's not fucking, you know... He's not doing what? I guess nuking. Not using nukes. Bro, Hagra fucking died. I'm officially giving up on 2022. Come on, man. He's a big boy. Big boys go down big, and they go down early. Oh, RS Golden Glory Tony has passed away. RIP to him. Careful not to say no cap on a stack for real, for real. I mean, guys. Banger TikTok stitch. Don't read the comments, though. What is this? Okay, let's get started early. Let's get started early, and what the fuck is this?
Substitute white lives matter for the swastika, by the way. Like, because that is what that is. It's a white supremacist slogan. I want to fucking get to the heart of this one more time for people who have any sort of, like, confusion around this, because white lives matter is a slogan that was created as a counter to black lives matter. It is no different than white power, which is the slogan that was created after black power during the civil rights movement. It's just PR. It is propaganda from white supremacists who try to deflect away the attention from black people saying, hey, we matter, stop killing us.
Oh, that's why black women find him hot.
That's funny. He talks like this all the time. He's misunderstood for real. Yeah, people just like to think he says things when he's a lot more reasonable than you guess. No, he's not. I don't think him clearly saying he wants to go death con on you know who is misunderstood. They're talking about Hassan, not Kanye, bro. He has good points and are great at conveying complicated issues and subjects, but sometimes his personality is insufferable. He's fine like 60% of the time. He's pretty conceited and jokingly misogynistic. Anyone who sits in front of a camera 8 hours a day is going to come across a little conceited. Even though he has man tendencies. I think that reading hate comments. No, these aren't bad. These comments are really good. Why are you saying these comments are bad? Guys, these are like, this is like rad lib stuff. What do you mean? I'm glad it's getting a little better because a few months ago, if you just typed Hassan in TikTok, recommended social are Hassan is anti-black. Yeah. Did you rank up yesterday? I did. This is the part of the broadcast where I tell you a little bit about my personal news, okay? Some people don't like how bro you can be. Yeah, but it's me. You know what I mean? It's me. And not only is it me, is it authentically me. It's also, I don't know how to describe it. Like, human beings are imperfect. You just got to check your worst behavior. You know what I mean? As best as you possibly can. But also, my demeanor, I think, is, like, pretty decent with, I don't know how to describe it. I think my demeanor is pretty, it's complementary to the commentary because that juxtaposition itself basically is what makes things a little bit interesting. And certainly makes people that normally would not listen to this kind of commentary pay attention to it. It just sucks that, like, that's been weaponized a lot. I mean, of course, anyone who cuts commentary for 8 to 10 hours is always going to have stuff that you can hit them on, no matter what. You can see me in a bad light. You can portray me in a negative light. You can portray me in a good light. But my goal is always to get people in through the door. As I've said time and time again, I see myself more as an entertainer. I am not an activist. I've never said I was an activist. I've always been an entertainer and an educator on top of that. So once the chat was a bunch of meanies, I mean, chat can't be a bunch of meanies. What if people like Tucker don't portray you at all? No, that's great. I'm happy that I was not involved in the latest Tucker saga. I saw the climate activists fucking up a Van Gogh painting. What did Van Gogh do to them? You know what I'm saying? I know protest is supposed to make you uncomfortable and stuff, but did they actually give you COVID? I don't think so. Let me see if I have a test. If I have a test at home, I'll take a look at it. Ben Shapiro has talked about trans people so much, you can cut a pro-trans segment out of it. No, I know. We've watched that before. That's Justin T. Brown's video. That painting was behind glass. But yeah, your juicers got COVID. I mean, holy fuck, TwitchCon was a super spreader, which is not surprising. I'm just happy for medical technology getting to the place it has gotten to. Where I'm happy that medical tech has gotten to the place it has gotten to with Paxlovid and shit like that, where, you know, it's still very clearly a problem. It's still very clearly an issue. And it sucks that we're just never... It sucks that we're not actually, able to legitimately take necessary steps. Especially with respect to accommodation for those who need it the most. Like people with disabilities. But anytime this sort of thing happens, I'm just reminded. I try to see the silver lining. You know what I mean? Which is that I remember 2 years ago, right, where hospitals didn't have space, where we did not have any vaccinations whatsoever, dude. Holy fuck, dude. I mean, the idea that people are anti-vaxxers blows my fucking mind, okay? I think about how incredible vaccines are regularly and how incredible, just medical technology is regularly. Nuts. Paxlovid... It's not great. Paxlovid is not the best. But it's still something. I got Paxlovid from my dad the other week and they told me to tell him not to take it at the same time as the Cialis. Destroyed any scrap of childhood innocence I still had right then and there. What? Dude, what the fuck? Before COVID, it was common for people to say that anti-vaxxers aren't hurting anyone, but I was always like, no, this is bad. Look where we fucking are now. I have always understood that anti-vaxxers hurt everyone, okay? They've always hurt. There's never been a time in history where it hasn't. Anyway, let's look at some good news here before we get to some serious news. Kai wants to play Valor. With Hassan?
Fuck no! That nigga's ass! Fuck no, bro!
No!
Fuck no! That nigga's fucking terrible.
Gonna play Valor with Hassan?
We are gonna play Valorant next week. He's already better than you? Of course, he's a fucking gamer, bro. The way Lobic still influences Twitch. Listen, Ludwig has shown once again that black culture influences culture and not the other way around, okay? That's it. This is why all those TikTok dances are originally created by like little black girls and not fucking, you know, some random white girl in Connecticut, okay? Straight up. There's no better representation. There's no better representation than of this cultural exchange, oftentimes culture vulture shit, not going the other way, okay? But it did go the other way. They all did it. Yeah, but there's a difference. They're making fun of them. It's not like, no one was like, man, that's such a cool-ass dance move. Let's all fucking pick this up and start doing it. It's done. It's done ironically. That's the point. Stand up and try, maybe in a little bit. Hit the lud. Please no. This is white racism. This is anti-white racism. You know it. This is a place where anti-white racism thrives, my friend. Hey, speaking of which, motherfucker got COVID.
This is my COVID diarrhea that nobody asked for. They want it.
So he was like, bro, I'm going to be fucking streaming later. You know, I'm no bitch, whatever. Boom. Turns out he's got COVID. Now I feel fucking, I'm worried. I was worried for him, but luckily he's staying with Lud. So, you know, he'll get taken care of. That's good that he's not like by himself. You know what I mean? But yeah.
So I'm feeling bad, so I bought this little testy thing, and the testy thing said two lines, right, which is positive. And as I got another one, and I did it again, it's positive again. I only got two vaccines last year, and then I didn't get a third one because I'm lazy. And then now I'm getting absolutely obliterated. Breathing is fine. I have a headache. All my muscles hurt, and it feels like I'm getting attacked in the muscles. Yeah, that's about it. I'll report tomorrow with more developments. Okay, bye.
So, I think like, I mean, I don't know what it is. I don't know what's going on. But, like, I feel like, If you haven't gotten COVID at this stage, even if you're vaccinated, like it still hits you the first time. It still hits you in the fucking face. But when you do end up getting it, and I mean, obviously this is my own personal anecdote, and by no means should you feel comfy. But I'm talking about my own personal experience with it, like. After I got it, and when I had it, it was awful, okay? It was so incredibly fucking awful that when I had it, it fucked my workout up. It fucked my workout regimen up. It definitely wasn't great. It took a while to recover physically from it, you know what I mean? And I think I got like a lighter version of it too. It wasn't like the worst of the worst after I was triple boosted, right? Thank God. And I will most likely get another booster as well. But triple boosted and got COVID. For me, internally, I do feel more comfortable with it. Especially when you compare how afraid I was originally of it. Is it more embarrassing to get it now, all late to the game? Not really. Have you had your new updated formula booster? No, I have not. I've been watching you for a few months. When I started, I subscribed to Ben Shapiro, Ladder, Crowder, Pedro, Jordan Peterson, Milo, and I was spamming in the chat about what Armenian Golgotcha. A lot has changed since then, and it's been an improvement. I don't understand why or what, but I think you should know. Thanks, I guess. Fuck yeah, man. That's what this is for. There's nothing embarrassing about getting COVID, especially if you've done the necessary things that you can to you know, take the adequate steps to protect yourself. Wait, hold on. I had an idea, and I wanted to fucking do it quickly. Sorry. Nothing embarrassing about getting COVID. Bolsonaro probably. No, Bolsonaro is embarrassing. That's different. That motherfucker got it like 100 times, bro. And he is like a fucking anti-vaxxer and shit. So that is the time when it is embarrassing. The thing I worry about with X, though, is that he's not exactly the beacon of health. You know what I mean? Thank God he's young, but it's not necessarily that he's not necessarily like a very healthy person, right? Hold on. I'm texting Kai real quick. Is OMADing Rice smart? I don't know. He's not 400 pounds. He fits in the healthy category by U.S. standards. No, I mean, I wouldn't say he's healthy. Not the healthiest man. XQC is like 100 pounds. He's 100 pounds and like 30 of it is just like straight G Fuel. 10 of it is toenails. Fuck do you mean healthy? The man, we go to dinner. You know what this man does? It's so funny. We go to dinner. We're at a Brazilian steakhouse. He puts salt on his hand and then just takes a shot of salt. I go, what the fuck was that? He goes, free taste. What do you mean? Free flavor. I was like, that is insane. And there's like little balls, the little Brazilian, like bread balls with cheese, you know, right in front of him. I'm like, bro, eat that shit. That's like really good. And he tries one. He takes a couple bites. He's like, eh, it's all right. My man knows what he likes. Those cheese balls are gas. Yeah. Pau de queijo. I have salt powder in my kitchen for seasoning. I take a finger to it and give it a lick from time to time. You guys are crazy. That's craziness. What the fuck? Why did y'all do this already? Why did you do this? Why? Bro, you guys are insane. Okay, I'm fucking blasting off, dude. Let's get started. Jesus Christ. Live TwitchCon is ripping everyone with COVID. Elon Musk. Canceling Starlink in Ukraine. Wants Pentagon money. New mass shooting in North Carolina. More didn't know. At this point, it's like mass shootings happen and it's a fucking juvenile. And on my end, I'm like, you know, on my end, I'm thinking, Like, it's just another day in America. Hard not to be fucking so incredibly blackpilled. We will talk about the mass shooting in a little bit, though. You were going to cover it. Wait, what? You're going to cover Urine Austin's live CNN appearance last night? What? Social media reacts to Fox News' contributors $28 Taco Bell lunch?
It was a comment that had heads spinning like a chalupa and was on hell.
Wait. Oh, shit.
Someone else wondered, how is that even physically possible? Also, don't think I'll take financial advice from this guy. One skeptic offered a challenge.
Film yourself eating $28 worth of Taco Bell in one sitting, no cuts.
John Iderola, STYT.
$28 Taco Bell meal, one taco, 48 Cinnabon delights. Even Taco Bell itself chimed in to show you can get a lot of burritos.
Wait, where is it? Where is me and Austin?
Times $2 burritos equals $28.
How much do you spend at Taco Bell normally?
I don't know. I've never ordered sober.
One guy drove himself to the nearest Taco Bell drive-thru.
That's crazy.
Exactly how this man spent $28.
That's crazy. We made it. Austin and I are on CNN, baby. Austin's going to love that. I mean, listen, I'm in mainstream media quite regularly, right? As you guys already know. And I'll tell you this much. Usually when I'm on a mainstream news platform, it's no good, okay? So if you told me one day CNN would be cutting coverage of, the Ass Blaster special at $28, and that was what was going to get me on fucking CNN, I would have laughed at you. Meanwhile, this motherfucker is eating Chick-fil-A. Mid-bite. Caught in fucking 4K. Memorialized. It's permanent now, boys. It's forever. Okay, here it is. Juice this tweet, by the way. I'm live and alive. And we're letting the fucking people know. We're letting the people know. We're welcoming the Normans into our own homes, okay? Austin Ox confirmed CNN double agent. You doing a COVID test live? Yeah, I'll do one. The best part about this is that, like, with the exception of going into H3H3 studio, which does kind of suck, I don't think I have COVID. I'll do a test. But even if I did, like, with the exception of going into H3H3 studio, I have not left my house at all. So at least like my impact would be limited, even if I did have it. But I don't. I don't think I do. We'll check. I did have guests over. That's true. I did have guests over. Kissing XQC, you have it. I never kissed XQC, but I did. The one fucking week I hang out with this motherfucker, he gets COVID. What is this? I have computer issues, by the way. Oh, fuck. I forgot to mention, this is the part of the broadcast where I tell you a little bit about my personal news. I have been playing more Valorant. I had a 5-win streak with Ness and Will last night. I ended the broadcast. I literally just went back in. I dove back in and I played fucking more Valorant, right? I had a 5-win streak offline with Nessua. And Will was getting crap. I mean, Will's starting to get really good with it. He's now ranked up to silver. I'm bronze 2. You didn't get the Overwatch 2 bag? No. How the fuck would I do that? I don't believe you since it's off stream. Well, it wasn't technically off stream. It was on Nezwa's stream. And you can actually see me. I think there was a clip from Nezwa's stream where I was like, where I was playing. You had a pop-off moment with the Vandal? Yeah. Are you destroying your computer live on stream? Potentially. I did get a nice triple kill. I usually always get a nice triple kill, though. I raised main. I main raise. Haven't heard much about your workouts. Feeling good? No, I haven't worked out since TwitchCon. Also known as COVIDCon. Yeah, I mean, this was one of those moments. Here. Here it is. Here's my 3K. This is me. Nessa was dead. He's watching me play.
Holy fuck!
I did get clicked on there, but are you going to play Overwatch 2? From what I understand, in order to get to ranked Overwatch, you need to get 50 wins. And understand, you know, that is already crazy. 50 wins, not 50 games, 50 wins. And that's already fucking crazy. Or is it 50 games? It's a new account. I don't have an old one. I don't have a new account. I'm going to have to do a new account. And here's the problem with that. It's 7 wins or 20 losses. Anyway, regardless, the fucking queue times are so bad. Seven wins, 20 losses. A game in Overwatch is like 5 minutes and not like 40 minutes in Valorant. Way faster. Oh, they fixed it? I literally have not played Overwatch because anytime I've tried to play Overwatch, whether on stream or off stream, I've always had issues with queue times. So I've decided to never play it for that reason. And anytime I look at like anyone playing Overwatch, I look at like XQC and it'll be like waiting 20 minutes. An 8 to 15 minute queue time is actually... Like, see, this is saying, nah, that's false. I play Overwatch. It's 8 to 15 minutes. That's not a reasonable queue time, my friend. That is literally the reason why I stopped playing not only Overwatch, but that is precisely the reason why I stopped playing fucking Escape from Tarkov. Is it because XQC is super high ranked? Is that why? That's high ELO wait time? Oh, okay. I didn't realize. I thought, like, everyone fucking had to wait. Because in the beginning, the first week, everyone was fucking waiting. So I was like, oh, God, this sucks. And it still sucks. Tarkov queues are decent now. Everybody always says that. Also, he's still learning Valo. Learning Overwatch would be too much on top. Not really. I think I have played Overwatch in the past. But, like, Overwatch gameplay is not dissimilar to Call of Duty. I've never played CSGO, but I have played Call of Duty. So why are you guys throwing up question marks? Guys, movement wise, oh my God, you guys are so fucking annoying. People are literally purposely misunderstanding. CSGO movement and Valorant movement are very different than Overwatch and Call of Duty movement. okay? Overwatch and Call of Duty movement, you can move around. Why are all the Overwatch weebs getting triggered right now? I'm not saying the actual game mechanics. Why is there a reason? Why is it that people who have played CSGO can pick up Valorant and play better than people who have never played CSGO? Because CSGO movement and Valorant movement are very similar, okay? You go into a map, you fucking learn every corner on the map, you learn every angle in the map. It's about literally finding your angle and not moving while you shoot or maybe counter-strafing a little bit. Whereas with Call of Duty or Overwatch, the games are way faster. It's a dynamic, it's a way more dynamic experience. It's a way different type of movement. Now, of course, this is one you got to play to learn. That's why that's not a true saying. No, I'm not saying it's easy. I'm just saying that I could probably pick up Overwatch faster than I could pick up Valorant. You're right about Valo CS. It's just the Overwatch movement being like COD is odd as all. But I think what you're saying is Overwatch is way faster than Valorant. Overwatch is like objective COD Halo with hero mechanics of Dota. Like, when you look at FPS shooters, the way I would try to broadly categorize it by movement and game mechanics, the way I would broadly categorize, like, pacing and movement is Overwatch is closer to Overwatch is closer to Call of Duty. And then I would say pacing, movement, strategy. Valorant and CSGO are in one category. And then you have milsims like EFT in a totally different category where there's no crosshair. Oh, I guess there's Team Fortress 2 as well. Yeah. Movement shooters are my fave, especially FPS games, but they're pretty much dead. I play a game called Diabolical. There's a tiny fucking community. I don't know why people keep saying Overwatch is like an FPS MOBA. I know that. I know that Overwatch has so many different unique characters and skills, and it's balanced in an entirely different way. It's not a fucking pure shooter in the same way that, Call of Duty is. I know. I understand that. I'm not even talking about that right now. I'm talking about the bare bones, the skeleton, okay? The skeleton of the game. The way you move around on the map, the way you can move and shoot, for example, the difference between aiming down your sights versus not. Movement and mechanics are closer to one another. But the reason why Overwatch has, the reason you're probably getting upset, this is by far your biggest controversy. I'm not saying anything weird. I think you need someone like fucking XQC or Tadic to say the exact same thing, so then you'll agree with it, because like they have more respect and legitimacy in this field. I don't know why the fuck people are getting upset at me for this, though. Overwatch and COD play absolutely differently. Overwatch is insanely fucking slow, clunky. COD is insanely fast-paced, especially respawn time. Okay. Valorant is more homophobic than Overwatch, though. Overwatch also has the best porn, which I think is important to note here. I mean, I think everybody agrees with that. At least I have a take that everyone will unite on. You know what I mean? Overwatch, best porn. Valorant and CSGO are tactical shooters. Overwatch, COD, etc. are not. I think that's why people are upset, because Overwatch lovers look at Overwatch and say, Overwatch has a lot of tactical elements that Call of Duty doesn't. Call of Duty is just like run and gun. Pure aim, fucking pure degeneracy. Overwatch has like skills. Characters have different skills. It's like a whole different level of balance. That's why people are getting mad. Call of Duty is not even pure skill. I take it back. It's who has the best cheats. COD is just about who has the best cheats. We're mad because you aren't playing. Here you go, bro. You good? Here, you want to... Say hi to the stream.
Hello, everyone. How you doing?
Here you go, bro.
Hi.
Here you go. Okay. Close the door. Yeah. Jack Manifold needed my American phone to make an American phone call. I saw him beefing with chat over the Overwatch for the last 15 minutes. It's been so funny. Apparently, Turkey passed a disinformation law, 1 to 3 years of prison if the government thinks the information you posted online is false. Do you know anything about that? I've heard about this, but it's not good. Not good at all. You should pit X's chat and yours against one another in Hell Let Loose. What the fuck is that? I think chatters are just being weird because movement isn't their normal metric for comparing shooters. Why? Movement is, like, incredibly important. I would say, okay, here's a take that maybe people will completely disagree with me on. But no, I think movement is how I would broadly, if I were to look at, like, a broad categorization, like, some weird way of trying to assign shooters and define, like, weird categories. Well, not weird categories, but, like, define categories for different types of FPS. I would say you can either do it on, like, game modes, which is pretty basic. BR, right? Like, BR versus Search and Destroy versus, I guess, like, Overwatch also has that train one, whatever the fuck that's called, you know, moving the bomb forward. Versus deathmatch, escort, payload. Yeah. So, other than that, though, because not every fucking game has that, and some games that do have SND, for example, don't fucking resemble one another at all. I would say that if I were to categorize first-person shooters, I would, instead of using game modes and whatnot, I would use movement as a way to categorize them. Movement, aim mechanics, and game mechanics is how I would categorize them, which is why I would say CSGO and Valorant, despite the differences, are very similar in movement and mechanics. Okay, that would be one category, which is more like, it's more like playing chess. It's about understanding the map, and I mean, every game needs you to understand the map, but like, it's about placement and angles and shooting while you're steady. That's a huge part of it. You can't move and aim. You can't move and shoot. And then I would say Overwatch, or I would say Apex and Call of Duty are obviously, again, movement shooters. Not as tactical, okay? And I would place Overwatch in there as well, movement-wise. And then lastly, I would put MILSIM shooters like Escape from Tarkov. Overwatch is fast-paced and very arcade-like, whereas Valorant is a lot more precise and mechanically dependent. all of these games are still tactical, and every single game still revolves around being able to click heads fastly. But time to kill and other components like that, I think, or rather, both time to kill and all the other components that involve movement are vastly different. It's all skill. It's just a different kind of skill. I don't know why people get so personal about it. Like, yeah, abilities. Yeah, hold on. All right, no problem. All right. Scared of CSGO realism? Yes, I'm scared of CSGO realism. It's like a three-way Venn diagram and they all dip into each other. Let's not pretend like CSGO is even in the same league as these kid games. Yeah, dude. Valorante child game, CSGO realism, gritty realism. Wouldn't that make Call of Duty the most realistic, though? Because it's even more realistic than CSGO. There are terms for this. Arcade shooters versus arena shooters versus milsim shooters versus Twitch shooters. What the fuck is a Twitch shooter? I mean, if you define video games by, like, what is the most realistic fucking video game, then, yeah, obviously, milsims win.
Are there any creators that you guys have seen here that you've gotten to talk to that you're like, oh, this is maybe not unexpectedly a good time, but you had a good time talking to them?
I like talking to Hassan. He's just easy to talk to because I'm like a shy person, I guess. Like, it's hard for me to start talking to people.
Yeah.
Hassan is just very, like, cool. Like, he's just open. Aww. He's just cool to talk to. Like, yeah. You know, it's easy.
Well, you have already done Hassan, though.
Yeah, I've talked to him before, but in person.
Damn, they want me to go on banter that bad, huh? No, I'm just kidding. I will be going on banter. I thought I was supposed to do it this week.
Person,
I think it'd be cool.
Are there...
so weird that every creator I've met is always like, yo, Hassan's actually a really nice guy, but they always think I'm not before they meet me. And I think part of that reason is because, like, so many people on the internet think I'm like this fucking crazy, like, I'm gonna cancel everybody type dude, you know what I mean? People, content creators tell me all the time that they're terrified of my community, not realizing that this community is, like, super kind, especially to anyone that's not me, you know what I mean? I think they just, like, see me yelling in my chat, highlights of that, and they think, like, oh, he's just, like, a short-tempered dude. Or they see chat canceling me, and they think, oh, my God, this community is so fucking aggressive. Meanwhile, it's just, it's totally different. It's so nice. And only at the top of the hour do people throw tomatoes, you know what I mean? Because they see, oh, at the top of the hour, there's a 6-second ad break. Well, that's fucking bullshit. But then they are reminded that, hey, you no longer want to see those ads. All you need to do is subscribe, which you can do for $5 or for free with Twitch Prime. It's odd because, like, I have two different forces, competing against one another. Oh, by the way, I'm going to run the ad break now. If you also get gifted a sub, you can avoid the ads as well. Here's the moment ad break. It's interesting because there are two different types of, like, communities on the internet. You have, like, rad libs that are further to the woke side that say I'm racist and, like, unapproachable, and then they'll get shocked when they actually tune in and they go, oh, wait, this guy's actually not the way that, like, other people have presented them. And then you have, on the other side, you have people who are like, oh, his community is super woke, and is SJW and like wants to cancel everybody. Meanwhile, I'm more of a, I would say I'm more in the center, I guess. Center left. Herschel Walker debate not in the title. That's tonight, 4 p.m. PST. Yeah, we'll watch the fuck out of that, obviously. For most people, you yell in chat or longtime chatters, we should know better. That's why you're like a disappointed dad. Yeah.